Thank you for checking out this video. My name is George. In this video, we will look at the necessary procedures for MicroPython language environment in using the Gorilla Cell Development Kit. I divided it into three simple steps. Number 1, ESP32 USB driver installation. Number 2, TonyPython IDE installation. Number 3, flashing MicroPython firmware to ESP32. So without further ado, let's begin. For the number 1, ESP32 USB driver installation. Typically, ESP32 uses CP210X family of USB to UART bridge chip. By installing this driver, you will be able to communicate with the ESP32 through the USB. You may begin by downloading the driver in your favorite search engine. So I will open my Chrome and I will type CP210X and then hit enter. Click the links from scilabs.com, which is the official website of Silicon Laboratories, manufacturer of CP210X chip. I will click this one, and under the downloads section, under the software downloads, look for the USB driver according to your operating system. I am using Windows 10, so I will be downloading the CP210X Windows driver. I will click this one. Give it some time until the download is complete. When the download is complete, go to its folder by clicking the Show in folder. Right click that one. Unzip. And open the folder. I am using Windows 10 64-bit. I will click this x64. If you are using 32-bit Windows, you need to use the x86 instead. I will double click. Then just follow and accept everything. When you see the check marks here in Silicon Laboratories, device updated, just click finish. Now let's proceed to step number 2, which is the TonyPython IDE installation. You may begin by downloading the TonyPython IDE from its official website, tony.org. Tony.org. So this is Tony. This is how it looks. I am using Windows 10, so I will click Windows. You may choose Mac or Linux. So give it some time until the download is complete. I choose TonyPython IDE because it is easy to use and beginner friendly. Besides, its overall user interface is beautiful and it is simple. So these are some other features. By the way, you can also use it for regular Python, but since we are learning embedded electronics, we will use it for MicroPython, which is a Python for microcontrollers. When the download is complete, you may install it by clicking the downloaded software. I click it. Then just click accept or next and follow through. I will accept. Click next. Click next. I will create a desktop icon. Click next and install. It's very simple to install. Okay. Great. Success. Tony is now installed. I will click finish. Oh, formal education will make you a living. Self-education will make you a fortune. By Jim Rohn. Click finish. Now let's proceed to the final step, which is the step number 3, flashing MicroPython firmware to ESP32. ESP32 is not shipped with MicroPython firmware as default firmware. We need to flash it or write a new firmware on it in order to be able to use the MicroPython language. Don't worry, it's very easy. Let's begin by downloading the latest firmware by going to MicroPython.org. Then under the download section, look for ESP32. It's in the bottom part. It's under ExpressIP ESP base boards. And under generic ESP32 module, click this one and go down. And under the firmware with ESP IDF version 3.0, I choose this one because it supports all other function of the ESP32. While version 4.0 or 4.x has some limitations. So I will choose the version 3.x and download the latest and stable version, which is version 1.13, because this in the top are still under beta testing. So let's download the version 1.13. It is the firmware we need to use for flashing to ESP32. Okay, it's downloaded. Let's check where it is saved. It is saved under downloads. Now that the download is complete, open TonyPython IDE to begin flashing the new firmware. So let's open the TonyPython by clicking the Tony. In the TonyPython IDE, we will first check if the ESP tool plugin is properly installed by clicking the Tools menu and under the Manage Plugins and look for the ESP tool. So it is currently installed in this location. If ESP tool is not installed, you may search for ESP tool, then click the install. So I will demonstrate it by going to this location. I will delete this one. You don't need to follow this one. I'm just showing you in case the ESP tool is not installed. As of now, there is no ESP tool. So you will search ESP tool. And here, open this one, ESP tool. And click this install. So it will install by itself. After that one, the ESP tool is installed. So you may close this one. We need the ESP tool for flashing the firmware to ESP32. Now let's begin flashing the MicroPython firmware to ESP32 by clicking the Tools menu, go to Options, and under the Interpreter, select here as ESP32 because we are using ESP32. And under this port or web REPL, select the Silicon Labs USB to UART bridge. In my case, it's COM3. And under here, install or update firmware, click this one. And select again the COM port, which is COM3. And under here, firmware, browse to the location of your downloaded firmware, which is this one. I select this one and click open. Make sure that under the flash mode, RAM image file or keep is selected. And the erase flash before installing is also checked. After that, click install. Give it some time. It will take some seconds or maybe a minute. In any case that there is an error like this one, you need to try again, but you need to press the boot button while it's uploading. Okay? Now, erasing flash, this may take a while. Now it's uploading, writing. Now 10%. So, complete. Now done. Just click close and click OK. Now for the final step, let's test our setup by running the following code. I will just make a code from machine. Import in. I will blink the LED. Pin, which is connected to pin 2, and set the pin direction as output. I will make a while loop. I will make it loop forever. First, I will turn on the LED. Then I will sleep delay for 1 second, and I will turn off the LED. Then delay for 1 second again. I will also import the time module by from time import sleep. Save this one. Let's say blink LED and click the run script here. And if you are able to see a blinking LED every 1 second, it means you successfully installed MicroPython in your ESP32. Yay! Congratulations! So, that's all for now. I hope you learned something from this. If you have any concern about this video, please do write your question in the comment box below. If you enjoyed this video, please do like and share this to your friends so that it can reach more people who might benefit from this. You might also like to visit my blog post at techtothinker.blogspot.com for more details. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you will be notified when a fresh video like this is uploaded. Thank you and God bless. See you on the next video. Happy tinkering! Bye!